Supposed to prove that I love you. You take advantage every chance you get. You break my heart at every chance you get. You let me know that every chance you get, you will protect me, but you're lying. We'll be right back.
show you two things. I'm gonna show you how you manually enter out to the CDU here, and on the route 2 page later on I will show you how the route export from ProITC will work also, how we will use our manually entered route. I really prefer entering the route manually because that's more realistic and makes more clear what you're actually doing, except for clicking and pointing and putting stuff. I don't really like that, and as far as my understanding goes, it's not usual that there are company routes available for every flight. So anyway, I'm showing you how you enter this manually. So we're going to Romeo on my mic again, and we're flying to Oscar Mike Delta Bravo to Dubai. Our flight number today is here is Fox 609, and we want a company route here. We go to the next page on the route and we enter the route that's also in the tutorial without the SID and the stars for the moment. We just enter the route. It's Leland as first waypoint, the SID exit, then it's the Lima 894 airway to the Keetel waypoint, which we don't enter here. We will enter the P570 airway, and the connection point between these two is Keetel, and it's recognized here. Entering it this way is a lot faster than entering all the connection waypoints. You just have to make sure that this fits. So sometimes some airways share a couple of waypoints and it just doesn't fit, or the CDU makes any errors. So you have to cross check if the waypoint is correct. If the CDU puts another one in here, you have to check on en route charts if this is correct, or what the issue is, or correct it if necessary. So you don't want to fly anywhere you don't want to fly, actually. So we have the Mike 762 airway in there, and our star entry point is Dubin. So that's it, that's the route already. Just make a short look on the legs. You would now cross check this with en route charts to make sure this is correct. I'm assuming it is. So, and that's it. We can activate execute, and it's in the box. Then we go to the initial reference page, and well, first of all, we have to set our load for the flight here. I totally forgot that now. So the fuel is 3270 kilograms. I fly in kilograms. If you do the LBS, I don't have to worry now, but it's in tutorials. We use the same values here. We go to the payload and enter 193.5 as your fuel weight. It's in there, and the FMC calculates the correct cargoes. As you notice, I'm flying a cargo, the cargo version, freighter version of the 777 here. Would do with the normal passenger version as well. So we have that. Then we're back in the performance center page. We got our zero fuel weights, which is exactly 193.5. We got a resale, which is 7. Now cruise altitude of 380, and the passenger max of 3.5. So good so far. Then we go to the turn derated and enter 65 degrees. As in the Maldives, there's all over the year the same temperature is around 30 degrees, so we don't have to really calculate it now. We just use it for that's it for the tutorial flight, because the temperature is more or less all the same. This will do very well here, so we leave it there. This will work here. If you're on other airports, you might calculate or degrade the engines a little bit less to have enough room. But the runway is quite long here, and the weather is fine, so this should be okay. Yeah. So, on the takeoff page, set flaps 5, set center gravity, which brings us 30% in the free. We'll set this later on when we have fully power, which we don't have at the moment. There are no wheel speeds calculated here because we don't have a departure. We don't have a sit, and we don't have a runway. More or less, we don't have a runway. That's why we don't have the wheel speeds calculated now. That's totally okay for the moment. So, go to the next page, see here, and well, that's good. So we have set the IDRUs, then we will load up. Pro ATC. I will do this, you won't see it. I'll just oh, where it's gone, I have to start again. I'm sorry you can't see this here, but well, no Pro ATC, so I just load up the flight and select the MD-11737 and JS-41 flight plan export, and that's all it is. So we see Pro ATC started up here. We will leave the time that it needs to get done. So already now, here at the moment, 1608 milligrams, wind is 240 at 14, so this will be 1.80, most likely. Temperature 30 to 25. That's quite nice weather. Visibility was 64,000 meters actually, 40 miles. Time colorless at 1.807 feet, scattered by 28,000. And not much wind up in the air. Alright, then we'll close that down again and set our barometric 0.008. We will traffic boost it a little. We already preset the course selector to 1.8 feet. Yeah, I got the keyboard input on here, so this wasn't working quite fine at the moment. Anyway, so we're good so far. We have Pro ATC. Let's see if the whether the Pro ATC gets us the same 240 miles. You add 1,000 kilometers, get it 28,000 to 25,000. Very well, very well. So, now, to be able to talk to the ATC, in fact Pro ATC, here, you have to activate the mic selector on VHF1 on the cabin side. If you load any startup state except the boarding dog, this will already be activated. If not, you have to do it manually. Click it, mic will show up here, and this should be all. So we skip some of our usual pre-flight preparation here. We do it the fast way, so we skip the frequencies to the CD frequency, which is 128.5, and we'll refresh.
Sheriff's delivery, DOE.
page, I want to show you how you import the properties you exported route. So you use the MD11747 format, and it you have to set the directories in ProRTC in the paths to folders tab to go into the 777 directory. I already done this before, so we go to route 2. We have to enter the information again. Fly to Dubai on the beach. In here, this is 689. We got it. So now you go to request, route request, and you see the exported route in there. If there would be other routes, you would have selection here. So we use this VRMM ONDB. Good. Okay. Execute. It's in there, and you see on the legs page, route 2 legs. We are on the correct route. That the same we entered manually is now in here. If you go to the 102 legs and route page and route 2, go to route, you see that this is also set here, so direct from Leland to BIPGO actually, and then the 894 airways entered. Well, Leland itself is on that airway. I don't know why ProRTC got this additional waypoint in here, but it doesn't matter, it's on the same airway, so this would work. All the other are more or less the same. We have some other crossing points here. We have the Golny waypoint instead of the Kitai waypoint to cross to P570. If we cross check on the en route charts, this should work actually. So yeah, this is how this would work if you take the route over ProRTC. As you see here, both routes are in there, so the route 2 is in dash blue and the active route is in magenta. So we can open the plan mode here and go to the legs page and increase a little. I go to one legs because it is a little bit more clear, and we will click through the route. This is the complete departure procedure, which is actually quite long. And there we go, Leyland, BIPGO, Problem and so on. As you can see, you just see one route, it's the magenta one, and you don't see the blue one. That's because they are exactly one over the other. So if we have the route 2 legs page, then we see it dash blue magenta mix because the route 2 is overlaid. And it's exactly the same route with the exact same waypoint, so you see the route is completely the same when you import it from ProRTC. It has other crossing points of the airways, this still works because there might be multiple waypoints where the airways can cross, or airways run one over the other on the same airway. So it's the same airway with two names or something, if that makes sense. So I don't know, I think I make it worse now. But I think you have understood what I'm telling you. So we go back to route 1 as we will fly our already entered route. Gets in the better now. So we're in there, so this is set very well. Then we can go to the before start checklist. We have the MCP set with the V11550, the heading of 183, and the altitude of 5000 as initial, expect 10,000 within 10 minutes. This checks takeoff speeds. It's 147, 147, 150. CEO pre-flight is completed. The trims. turn back on the runway and back credit. So
and
we do
the ground cockpit.
Hi, Captain.
We're all set to go up here. We've been cleared to push and start at your discretion.
Roger that, ready for push. Power and air are clear, doors closed. We are ready for pushback. Please park the brake, please.
Okay, parking brake is on.
Clear for push. Seats, yeah.
Alright, and we already start the engines, it's no long turn, so the engine start. Go to the engine page. I really love auto start, don't have to mind anything, let's just see if the N2 comes up, get fuel in, and the 777 just rest completely alone. That's so awesome.
So 42 might vacate next right, enter the apron at Victor, parking stand 11.
Next right, Victor, 11 42 9.
427 Victor Foxtrot, contact Manchester, 124.2.
Bus is complete,
42 Victor Foxtrot. Tap 25 stay okay, right, take off 210 degrees, one
pressure's normal.
Okay sir, tow bar is on, pin is out, watch the pin on the right.
Alright guys, thanks. You're cleared to disconnect. We will be watching for the pin and the release from guidance on the right side of the airplane. And we'll see you guys next time through.
Roger that,
Captain.
Roger
that, Captain.
Roger
that, Captain. Roger
Stone 40 right, vacate next right, enter the apron of Victor, parking stand 8.
Bay is crossing the control zone boundary now, no height restriction. Stay under the height restriction, don't turn for zone. So about report passing 2,500 feet. Okay,
you got here actually. theory.